John. Big John.
Every morning at the church, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Nobody seemed to know where John called home. He just drifted into town and stayed all alone. He didn't say much, he kind of quiet and shy. And if you spoke at all, you just said hi to Big John. Somebody said he came from
Detroit,
where he got in a fight over a Cajun queen, and a crashing blow from a huge right hand sent a Louisiana fella to the promised land. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Then came the day
when the church house rocked,
when a timber cracked and men started crying. Miners were praying and hearts beat fast, and everybody thought that they'd breathed their last except John. Through the dust and the smoke of this man-made
smell
walked a giant of a man that the
members
knew well. Grabbed a sagging timber and gave out with a groan, and like a giant oak tree just stood there alone. Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
And with all of his strength, he gave a mighty shove. Then a
member
yelled out, "There's a light up above." And 20 men scrambled from a would-be grave. And now there's only one left down there to save Big John. With jacks and timbers, they started back down. Then came that rumble way down
in his stomach.
And the smoke and gas belched out of that
mouth.
Everybody knew it was the end of the line for Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Now they reopened that
church.
They just placed a marble stand in front of it. These few words are written on that stand.
Never forget to feed your pastor.
Big John.
Big John. Big John.
Big Bad John.
Big John.
Big John.
Big John.